Now coming to next lecture. So till now we have seen wave impedance, equation for wave impedance for TE mode of propagation and TM mode of propagation, right? And we know that wave impedance for TEM is intrinsic impedance because multi-conductor transmission line supports TEM wave, which doesn't contain any cutoff frequency, right? Now we know the expression for cutoff frequency, that is given by FC equals to C by under root of M by A whole square plus N by B whole square, right? Now this is expression for FC we have derived in previous lecture, that is given by C by 2 under root of M by A whole square plus N by B whole square, right? Now coming to this, see here we have the terms called dominant mode and degenerate mode, right? We have the terms called dominant mode and degenerate mode. Now these two terms are defined based on cutoff frequency of a mode, right? These two terms are defined based on cutoff frequency of a mode, right? Now what is dominant mode? Now coming to first one, now what is mean by dominant mode? The mode which contains low cutoff frequency. The mode which contains low cutoff frequency is nothing but dominant mode. Now we have to find out what is dominant mode of a rectangular waveguide, right? Now coming to, see, it supports TE mode or TM mode, right? It supports TE mode or TM mode of propagation. Now coming to this TE mode of propagation, except TE00, right? Except TE00, all modes are supported by rectangular waveguide. Now coming to this TM mode of propagation, M should be greater than or equals to 1 and N should be greater than or equals to 1, right? Except TM00, TM01 and TM10, right? TM10, M should be greater than or equals to 1 and N should be greater than or equals to 1. Both these two conditions, right? For these values only it supports TM mode of propagation, right? Now we have to find out which has least cutoff frequency, whether it is TE mode of propagation or TM mode of propagation. The cutoff frequency equation represents same, right? Now coming to TE00, right? TE00 or TM00, these modes are not supported by rectangular waveguide. Why? Because all field components will get vanished, right? Now coming to TE10, right? Coming to TE10 and TM10, right? TM10, it supports but it doesn't support because here all field components will get vanished. Now let us find out cutoff frequency for TE10, right? Now what about the values of A and B? Right? Now what about the values of, because to find out the cutoff frequency, here we know that M equals to 1 and N equals to 0. Now what about the values of A and B? See, we know that rectangular waveguide, now this is your rectangular waveguide, this is B value and this is A value, right? Now this is B value and this is A value. Always A is greater than B, right? Always A is greater than B. Now this B value is half of A, or B value is greater than half of A, or B value is less than half of A, right? B value is greater than half of A and B value is less than half of A, and B value may be half of A. Now for the standard rectangular waveguide, this is follow. B equals to half of A. For a standard rectangular waveguide, the followed dimension is B equals to half of A. Now for the standard rectangular waveguide, it is 1.2 centimeter. It is 1.2, okay, I will say this later. Now for the standard rectangular waveguide, B equals to half of A, right? Either B value is A by 2, B may be, it supports, see, it may follow any of this criteria. But for the standard rectangular waveguide, B is half of A, right? B is half of A. Right. Now coming to this, now TE 10. Now calculate cutoff frequency. Here you will get C by 2A. FC you will get it as C by 2A. Right. FC you will get it as C by 2A. Now if you go for TE 01. Now TE 01 it is supported by rectangular waveguide, and TM 01 it is not supported by rectangular waveguide. And here FC you will get C by 2B, right? FC you will get C by 2B. If you compare this, TE 01 has least, TE 10 has least cutoff frequency because A is greater than B, right? Because A is greater than B. If you, now if I consider, see, consider A equals to 2 centimeters and B equals to 1 centimeter, right? If I consider A equals to 2 centimeter and B equals to 1 centimeter, here you will get C by 4 and here you will get C by 2, right? Now which value is lesser? This value, right? Now the dominant mode for the rectangular waveguide is TE 10 mode. The dominant mode for the rectangular waveguide is TE 10 mode. Now let me briefly explain. Now the cutoff frequency, right? The cutoff frequency expression we have derived in previous lecture. Now that is given by C by 2 under root of M by A whole square plus N by B whole square. Now based on this cutoff frequency, two different modes are represented. One is dominant mode and another one is degenerative mode. These two modes are defined based on the term cutoff frequency expression. Now what is mean by dominant mode? The dominant mode is nothing but the mode, any mode, either it may be TE mode or TM mode, any mode TE, because rectangular waveguide supports TE or TM mode of propagation. Now among that modes of propagation, which, whatever the mode that has least cutoff frequency, right, whatever the mode that has least cutoff frequency, that particular mode we call it as dominant mode, right? The mode which contains low cutoff frequency is nothing but dominant mode, right? Now rectangular waveguide supports TE mode of propagation or TM mode of propagation, right? Now under TE mode of propagation, except TE 00, it supports all modes. Now coming to TM mode of propagation, M value should be greater than or equals to 1 and N value should be greater than or equals to 1, right? Now consider case 1 where M equals to 0 and N equals to 0. TE 00 and TM 00, these two modes are not supported by rectangular waveguide. Now coming to case 2 where M equals to 1 and N equals to 0. TE 10 is supported by rectangular waveguide and TM 10 is not supported by rectangular waveguide because here all field components will get vanished. Now calculate cutoff frequency for TE 10. Here you will get C by 2A. Right, here we don't know the value of A. Right, we don't know the value of A. Here you will get C by 2A. Now consider case 3 where M equals to 0 and N equals to 1. That is TE 01 and another one is TM 01. TM 01 is not supported by rectangular waveguide because here all field components will get vanished. Right. Now if I calculate cutoff frequency, here you will get C by 2B. Now A is greater than B. Now consider A equals to 2 cm. Just I am brief considering it. Consider A equals to 2 cm and B equals to 1 cm. Now if I consider A equals to 2 cm, here you will get C by 4 and here you will get C by 2. Now among these two values, the least value you will get for TE 10. Right? That's why TE 10 mode is dominant mode for rectangular waveguide. Now coming to next term, that is degenerate mode. Degenerate or degenerative modes. Dominant mode is single, that is TE 10 mode is dominant mode for rectangular waveguide because it has least cutoff frequency, right? Now degenerative mode, right? Now what is mean by degenerative mode? Now the two modes with same cutoff frequency, two modes with same cutoff frequency we call it as degenerative modes. Their dominant mode is a single mode, that is TE10 mode, which has least cutoff frequency. Now coming to degenerative modes, two modes which has same cutoff frequency, right? Now two modes, let me define that. Now TM11 and TE11. Now this contains same cutoff frequency. If you want, you can check it also. Now TM21 and TE21, right? This contains same cutoff frequency, and TM31 and TE31, right? This also contains same frequency. Now if you see this TM23 and TM32, this doesn't contain same frequency, right? If you see this, M and N values should be same. M and N values of a particular mode should be same, right? Degenerative modes are nothing but two modes with same cutoff frequencies, right? Two modes with same cutoff frequencies, and this is possible only when M and N values of two modes are equal. M and N values of two modes are equal. Whatever the two modes that is containing same cutoff frequency, those we call it as degenerative modes. And this is possible only when M and N values of two modes are equal, right? M and N values of two modes are equal. Now this is about degenerative modes, which is nothing but two modes having same cutoff frequency, and this is possible only when M and N values of those two different modes are equal, right? Now coming to next one. Now let me solve problems. Now coming to first problem. The dimensions of waveguide, are 2.5 centimeter cross 1 centimeter, and frequency is 8.6 gigahertz, right? Calculate cutoff frequency and guided wave. Now this is the problem. Right? Now the given the dimensions of waveguide that are 2.5 centimeter cross 1 centimeter, and the frequency is 8.6 gigahertz. Now using these two values, one is dimensions and another one is frequency, we have to calculate cutoff frequency and guided waveguide. Here mode is not mentioned, right? If they doesn't mention mode, you have to consider it as dominant mode, right? If mode is not given in the problem, now consider it as dominant mode, which has least cutoff frequency. Now the dominant mode of rectangular waveguide is TE10 mode, right? Now what is the value of M for TE10 mode? M equals to 1 and N equals to 0, right? M equals to 1 and N equals to 0. Now the dimensions are given as 2.5 centimeter across 1 centimeter. Now among this, what is A value and what is B value? As I have already said, A is greater than B, right? A is always greater than B. Now A value is 2.5 centimeter and B value is 1 centimeter. If you see this, preferred criteria is A is, now B value is greater than A by 2, right? Preferred criteria is B value is greater than, sorry, B value is less than A by 2, preferred criteria. Either you may get less than A by 2 or greater than A by 2 or equals to A by 2, right? D value is less than A by 2, but for the standard rectangular waveguide, we follow B equals to A by 2, right? Now we know A value, B value. Now what is expression for FC? That is C by 2 under root of M by A whole square plus N by B whole square, right? Now substitute these values. Now the C is 3 into 10 power 10 centimeters divided by 2. Now the M value is 1 and the A value is 2.5 whole square. If you solve this, now FC you will get 6 gigahertz. FC you will get 6 gigahertz, right? Now we have to calculate next lambda g, right? We have to calculate next lambda g. Now lambda g that is given by, right, lambda g that is given by lambda naught of under root of 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square, right? We know the expression for lambda g. Now that is given by lambda naught by under root of 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square, right? See, we know fc that we got it as 6 gigahertz, right? Now using this fc, calculate lambda c that is given by c by fc, right? 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter divided by 6 gigahertz, that is 6 into 10 power 9. Here you will get 5 centimeter. 30 by 6, here you will get 5 centimeter, right? Now similarly in question, frequency is given, right? Frequency is given 8.6 gigahertz, right? 8.6 gigahertz frequency is given. Now using this, calculate lambda naught that is given by C by A. 3 into 10 power 10 divided by 8.6 into 10 power 9, right? 8.6 into 10 power 9. Now calculate this. Finally, you will get 30 by 8.6, right? 30 by 8.6. Finally, you will get 30 by 8.6. And this value you will get 3.4 centimeter, right? This value you will get 3.4 centimeter, right? Now substitute these values. Now lambda g equals to, now what is the value of lambda naught? 3.4 divided by under root of 1 minus 3.4 by lambda c is 5. If you solve this lambda g, you will get 4.6 centimeter, right? 4.6 centimeter. Now this is how to calculate lambda g and fc, right? Given dimensions, always a is greater than b, and the frequency is given, right? Now mode is not mentioned, right? If they doesn't mention mode, consider it as dominant mode. Now the dominant mode for rectangular waveguide is TE10 mode. You know m value is 1 and n value is 0, and a and b values are given. We can calculate fc. Now the expression for lambda g that is given by lambda naught by under root of 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square. We got fc, right? Using that fc, we can calculate lambda c, and the frequency is given. Using that frequency, we can calculate lambda naught, right? Substitute that values, you can calculate lambda g, right? Now this is about first problem, right? Now coming to second problem. Now the remaining problems I will say in next class, right? Thank you.